Alright, welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman.
I'm a game developer.
Today we're going to find a way to create
unlimited levels.
A quick update on the contest. You can now add a video or trailer to your game. Whoa, today is Sunday. So, whoa, you still have a lot of time. Let me show you the demo. Okay, so here's the demo. And yes, this looks like your regular platform game.
But is it?
Let's try to pass this level. Let's go up here.
Jumping.
He's a red ninja.
A very squirrely looking ninja. Okay, now we're in level 2. Okay, so wow, we don't have more levels. If you went to the storyboard editor, you can see that we only have one frame. And if you went to the event editor, you can see that we have only 8
events.
Let's go over the assets. Okay, so here's the ninja. It's just a regular active object.
2 directions.
Here are the bricks
or blocks.
They're just a static objects. Here are the spikes.
It is also an active object.
Here's the door, also an active object. I'm using the physics engine and I'm using these 2 pictures in the background. We're gonna use these as maps to create our levels. We have 2 maps. Okay, you don't have to include them in the game. Once you create the maps, you can't delete them. Okay, we have a counter here, but we don't actually need the counter. Okay, so let's open the example file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below
where you can download the free version.
There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create
commercial games.
But you can use the free version for this example. If you run this frame, you'll notice that nothing happens. Let's go to the event editor and let's do the usual collisions. Our object collides with one of these boxes, he stops. Our object leaves the play area.
On the left or right.
He stops. If our character leaves the play area at the bottom, we restart the frame. And if we collide with the spikes, we restart the frame. Okay, so that's done. If you run the frame, you notice that nothing happens still. At the start of the frame, when global value A is equal 0, then we're going to create an object. We're going to create a box. Okay, so but now we can't tell where we're going to place the boxes. So we're going to use this map here.
This will be level 1.
Now we're not going to use this for the actual game. This is just for us to be able to tell where to place the stuff. Let's place our first box. Create object. Over here. Create another object. Over here. Yet another object. Here. On the frame. That's starting to look not too bad. Now I'm not gonna do it perfect for this example. If you take your time, you can probably do it
better or more detail.
Okay, so I'm gonna pause the video and I'm going to do the rest. We're gonna add the hero. Place him over here. And we're gonna add the door. And we're gonna place the door over here. Let's remove the map.
We don't need that anymore.
And let's run the frame. Let's play it. If we collide with the door, we're going to add 1 to value A. And we're gonna restart the frame. So let's make level 2.
Bring our stencil.
And we're gonna do the same thing. Value 1. Delete all this and we can start over. Here, here, create object. Let's create the hero. It's gonna be here somewhere. We need to create the door, which is going to be, let's see, somewhere around here. Now we can probably put some spikes there. Let me place some evil spikes somewhere. One here, one say over here. Let's remove the stencil and let's run the game.
Come on, Red Ninja, you can do it. It is only level 1.
It should be easy. Okay, level 2. Whoa, I fell. And you can see that you can reduce the size of your game
by a lot.
If you liked this video,
hit the like button.
And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first
and top comment.
And today's top comment is
No Shiva.
When I was a boy, imperial walls and towers used to make me feel so safe.
And the first comment is Joshua Jones.